I am Chris Cuomo. Welcome to primetime, but more accurately, just welcome to the land of confusion. Is there anything more to say? Really, do any of you not get what's happening? I know you go to your respective partisan corners, especially at this time of night, for sucker, S-U-C-C-O-R, not S-U-C-K-E-R. I don't judge. Tell me why I'm right to hate him. Tell me why I'm right to love him. Does anybody really need to tell you anything? There he is, hair blown majestically, reshooting the scene for his own ad. I hold rallies, and I tell you to ignore masks, and I rip mine off as I vanquish the virus because I am a leader. Fear not, COVID. What a bunch of bullshit. Going back to the White House, if you want to know the reality, the truth, okay? The virus is the truth. The virus doesn't care about left and right. The virus does what's reasonable. You give me a chance, I'll spread. You keep away from me, you don't give me a chance, I run out of hosts, I die. I am the truth. If you're doing the right thing, you don't see me that much. If you're doing the wrong thing, you do. The White House is literally what we fear the most, a rash of contagion called a cluster. You want a metaphor? You've got a president who was a drunk driver who is pushing others to drive drunk. That's what he is. Do I want to see a drunk driver get hurt? Hell no. But I worry more about the people he hits. And I love seeing him do that victory lap in that limo. Thank God. You know why? I knew that meant he has to be okay. Not the people who were in there with him, PPE up to their nose. Now they got a quarantine. He doesn't give a damn. And now I don't have to feign any extra measure of compassion. Because he went out there. Whatever happens now is on him. The White House is a cluster. He returned to a cluster and took his mask off. That is COVIDiocy. He's a COVIDiot. You're disrespecting the president. No, he disrespected the presidency. All that's left is the residue of outrage, because that's the only emotion I have. He does and tells you to do everything the experts say not to, even after getting the virus. See, that's the truth. There is no change. He didn't beat the virus. He's not better than anybody who didn't beat the virus or who takes time. He's not stronger than I am. He got every advantage. He has use of all the things he denies the rest of us. He's supposed to get tested every day with a test that you can turn around quickly and know what's going on. Did he do them? Did he even use what's at his disposal that the rest of us are desperate for, that our kids need in our classes that he doesn't even discuss? No is the answer. Why? Show us the results. His doctor, I don't want to go backwards. Get out of the way. Show us the results. Show us that he tested negative on Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday. Because I'll tell you something, I'm no doctor. We're about to have Tony Fauci on in the next block. He is. You think you get sick the next day after being exposed to somebody? He would have to be so immune compromised that he'd never get out of the hospital, God forbid. So he was sick before. When? Why would they tell us? Why would they tell us? It's a mendacity machine. Kelly, I'll never lie, McEnany. That's probably the way to let someone know you're going to lie to them the best. I tell you, I love you, honestly. Somebody says honestly to you, you know they had an inclination to not be honest. But you saw him tonight, highly contagious. He has to be. It is the science of it. I know he was in the hospital. I know he had 24-hour care. I know they gave him 2 experimental treatments, but it was no big deal. What if that young woman's husband had access to what he had access to? What about if everybody's husband and wife and kid and son and daughter and aunt and uncle and grandparents had access to that kind of care or just tests to let them know what was going on and give them a chance to fight? How different would our situation be? The virus is the truth. And this president is a walking lie. Or, as my brilliant writer says, liability. L-I-E-ability. Good one, Susan. Why is he saluting? A salute is a gesture of respect. Literally every aspect of his pandemic experience and response exhibits disrespect. I am not upset because I am surprised. I am not upset because I am judging. I'm upset because so many of you contact me sick and desperate and scared. And I can do nothing. And this man who can do everything does nothing.